whispering mandalas. This is the first video in a new series that I hope to create periodically, where I will be creating different mandalas, not only to provide some visual stimulation and relaxation, but primarily to serve as a tutorial of sorts, as well as to encourage and hopefully even inspire others to take up this wonderful art. Mandalas are easy to draw. If you can hold a pencil, you can draw a mandala. They are affordable. Again, they only require a pen or pencil and paper. But above all else, they are relaxing and even spiritual and meditative and quite rewarding. Before we get started, and just for the purpose of this first video, I wanted to provide a brief background on the mandala for anyone out there that doesn't know what it is. The word mandala is from the classical Indian language of Sanskrit, loosely translated to mean circle. A mandala is far more than a simple shape. It represents wholeness and can be seen as a model for the organizational structure of life itself, a cosmic diagram that reminds us of our relation to the infinite, the world that extends both beyond and within our bodies and minds, describing both material and non-material realities. The mandala appears in all aspects of life. The celestial circles we call Earth, Sun, and Moon, as well as conceptual circles of friends, family, and community. A mandala is a concentric diagram that can consist of anything your mind can imagine, whether it's circles, organic plant-like shapes, squares, or drawings of animals and people. There is no limit to what a mandala can consist of. The only real requirement is repetition around the mandala. Beyond that, it's whatever you can come up with. All right then, let's get started. Grab a piece of paper and any writing instrument you have laying around. Feel free to pause this video at any time. In this video, I'll be using Crayola colored pencils in three colors, yellow, red, and orange, and two shades of each, one light and one darker shade, with the darker of the shades being used for the outlines. Start off with a circle drawn at the center of the paper. This center somewhat represents and is a metaphor for the center of your being, or the center of life. And the circle itself represents the seed that you're planting, from which the mandala will grow. And now I've just decided to randomly create eight petal-like shapes around the seed. And using the darker orange color for the outline, and then coloring them all in with the lighter orange color. This is the great thing about mandalas. Just randomly draw whatever you like, whatever inspires you from step to step, making sure you stay pretty much concentric around with your designs around the mandala. Then you can see I've drawn eight more yellow leaf-like shapes containing the orange petals and colored that in. And now I'm proceeding to create eight more orange petals in between the yellow petals that I've created. And then I'm creating little yellow petals, kind of like the orange ones I've already created, within each of these new orange petals. And now you can see the yellow, little yellow designs show up as I fill in all the orange petals. I enjoy creating these organic flower-like mandalas the most. Now I'm just randomly creating once again something new to go with this shape in a completely different direction. Just a new kind of leaf or petal-like design. As you can see, I created eight of those coming out of the orange petals. And now I'm just adding some extra little detail each of the new red leaf designs. And now I'm just going around and filling in all of the red petals or the leaves, making sure to leave the white of the little triangle designs I've created within each of the red petals. And then I've actually filled in those white little triangle spaces with yellow. And once again, just randomly going off in another direction, feeling inspired and just creating yellow leaves or petals next to the red ones I just created. Now I'm filling those in, and I've also added some orange little designs to the leaves. So now that all eight of those curving red designs have been filled in, I'm just now adding some additional detail to all eight of those orange petals that I've created. Remember, you want to repeat the same design that you create and keep it symmetrical or concentric as you go around the mandala. And there you can see what I've done so far. Petals. Now I'm creating some smaller petal shapes between each of the orange petals using red, using the darker color as the outline. And now I've just decided to create some circles and to fill those in, some dots on each of those newly created petals, red petals. This or go back at any point if you want to color or draw along with me. Now at this point I really felt that there was nothing else more that I could create with this mandala, so I just randomly decided to create a frame for it. Outside the red petals to separate them from the background, and you'll see that in a few moments. I decided to just randomly add some leaves coming in from all four corners of the border and give them some leaf-like detail. And then I simply colored in all the four leaves orange. And now I've taken my dark red pencil and proceeded to color in the entire background that was once yellow. And now you can see that I'm not coloring past the dark yellow border that I've colored in outside of the red, of the eight red petals, so that the red petals mandals have a yellow petal outside of them, which separates them from the red background or the dark background. And now I just decided to add some additional detail and fine touching to the mandala, and there we have it, a completed mandala. And that's all it really takes, just randomly drawing different shapes and designs and curves and taking it wherever you want to go with it. Just remember to make sure that you repeat and use a lot of repetition in each design that you create as you go around the mandala. So thanks for watching. I hope you found this somewhat relaxing and maybe even inspired to take this up yourself and give it a try. Until next time, take care.